Now, coming to where we are today, as far as the model of journalism is concerned, and the entire political corporate nexus, in one sense, Jaggi R. Jagannathan wrote a piece which I was a little surprised by. And I mean, I'd just like to take a quick kind of test here. I mean, the thesis there was that he should allow corruption because if he cracks on corruption, it'll hit growth. Because a lot of Indian growth is because of corruption. So how many of you agree with that? That we should not compromise growth even if we take a soft hand on corruption. Does anyone agree with that? Okay, not in public, clearly. You do. Basically, the thesis that every developing economy goes through a crony capitalism phase before it hits.
Even Japan, I mean, for being such a good country, it has its crime and its government.
Yeah, of course, even Singapore has corruption, but I mean, I don't think you can compare that corruption to. Okay. Okay, I'm quite fond of Jaggi, but yeah, I get what you're saying. Sorry, you were saying, man.
What they say in general, not me, but in theory in general, is that if corruption starts to eat away at the soul, which in China, to a certain degree, they're saying it has started to about a few years back, that's when the anti-corruption campaigns start to take force. Now, it's very difficult to compare a China or Vietnam model to an India model, but I do think one has to think contextually about where in our growth phase and what are the bigger battles that we have to deal with. And how, what kinds of corruption you do it. So I'm not saying it's black or white, I guess. And okay. I'm saying we should.
The young man there in great shape in the corner, yeah.
I think part of the slowdown the country is facing right now is because of the climate of corruption.
It is because of the climate of corruption.
I said partly, right? And for policy making, which is
right.
So actually, now you have done a bunch of exposés, and I haven't named them all, but Google Josy Joseph and you'll see it's a fairly long list and an illustrious career. As a journalist, of course, nothing is as juicy as getting a whole bunch of corporate corruption. But having a perspective as a journalist, seeing what corruption does, I mean, you don't report for pink papers, but I know you know a lot more than people who report on business. If you were just to step back and kind of wear a hat which is not an investigative journalist, do you think journalists saying this in the larger context is alarming that let's tolerate corruption? Or do you think there is some wisdom to it in the bigger context that every developing economy goes through a crony capitalism phase before it hits an efficient market?
See, I too did some amount of economics in my master's. So we can find enough theories to fit most arguments. But I think in Indian context, it's not... And I used to work with Jaggi in DNA for years, and I'm quite close to him. And knowing Jaggi well, he has to make an argument, so he's just making it. He's a very smart Alex. So, but I think it's a bullshit argument to make because your corruption is snatching away bread from that last Indian. And you got 35% Indians malnourished. You got 30 crore people without electricity, and still the government will have the courage to say that entire India has been electrified.
Is
or
electrified
villages.
Yeah.
You have, I mean, you are worse than Sub-Sahara outside of this club. But you don't want to acknowledge it. So then to say that corruption is okay because of my cities will get lit up and Quorum will have a good crowd, I mean, that's hypocrisy, right? So I think we are talking about the fact that, look, man, my corruption is okay and me and my friends can be corrupt. If you go and die of malnourishment, I'm okay with it, you know? That's insensitive. That's what's happening in the country today. See, there's a very deadly coming together of powers. For years, I used to believe and argue and fight in the very many jobs I had, and I left most of my jobs because my stories wouldn't go through. I used to say that corruption is a great danger to this country. But then I only saw corruption coming together with the political power of the day, whoever it was, India government, Congress, whatever government it was. But for the first time, you can see the two biggest dangers to India are now aligned with the big money politics of this country. One is a majoritarian politics of the worst kind, and second is the dirty corporate money. And sir, there is no crackdown on corruption. Corruption has been centralized. So you should know the talk of town that how today, if you have a big real estate deal to be fixed in Gurgaon or surroundings, you got to go to a certain building in New Delhi, I don't want to name the building, venerated by millions of people. And such stories are all over. So corruption has been centralized. And mind you, I just want to, because I'm just presuming good number of the people here who are sitting and listening to such boring talk at such good time, are linked to startups. See, all over the world, autocratic rulers, authoritarian rulers do not tolerate free market. And you just need to look at Putin to know what he does. They will concentrate the power of markets to a few hands, because of which my prediction is, if we have majoritarian autocratic rulers, I'm not necessarily talking to Modi alone, coming in this country continuously, what it is going to do is it will ruin the robust startup ecosystem we have. You know, in a few months' time, your Flipkarts and your Ola and everything will have to be dependent upon the broadband that Jio provides you.